I'm just listening about the hair conversation, and you're so mad at the waves and the wigs.
It looked terrible. Absolutely horrible.
How about for those who know how to take care of them?
They still look terrible. They look horrible. I don't date women who wear wigs. I don't date them
Why?
because I want you. I want to smell your hair. I want to feel the hair that God gave you, not someone's hair that you bought. And what, here's the thing that you guys don't think about. Y'all always talking about spirituality and spirits and energy. You never met that person that whose hair you've glued on top of your head. You don't know what spirits and energy that person carried inside of them, inside of that, and you got their DNA on your head.
But it's already dead. Like hair is dead. This hair is dead. It's not alive. It's
So
dead.
why put it on your hair? Why put
To
something
remember.
dead? Why put something dead on a live person?
Because maybe we want it, we like it, it makes us feel beautiful, it makes us feel better.
Why you can't feel beautiful in the hair that God gave you?
It's just as the same thing as saying, we shouldn't like, do you have something against girls like putting on nails and like that,
I'm
doing
okay.
acrylics and
So
everything?
let me explain where I am.
Same thing. It's
I'm a,
same
hold on,
thing. It's
no, hold
the
on,
same
hold on,
thing.
hold on, hold on. No, it's not the same thing. It's not. I'm
It
cool
is
with
the same thing.
you. Okay.
Okay, continue. Okay, go on, go on.
I don't mind women wearing makeup. I don't want my women wearing lashes that are within reason. Within reason. And I don't mind women getting their nails done. I think it looks great as long as they're not 9 inches long. I don't want to date a woman that looks like Edward Scissorhands. Just out here. I'm not doing that. You can't even wipe your butt cleanly. If you got nails that are too long, you cannot properly wipe your butt. That thing stank. Because if your nails are this long, you'll punch or something. You out here like Freddy Krueger. That's unsanitary. Now, here's the other thing. Wigs are not cheap. They're very expensive. Wigs are not cheap. They're very expensive. Why are you out here 312 pounds with a wig on? Why can't
Because
you
it
take,
makes you.
well, why can't you take that money, hire a personal trainer, and get your body in shape? They
We have
spend,
women who've got like great bodies and they still wear the wigs.
which is a shame because I look at those women and been like, damn, I could have dated you.
It's got nothing to do with having a great body. It's got nothing to do with it's like it makes you feel better as a person. Like
Okay,
what you just
hold
said.
on,
There's a
Anna.
difference. There's no difference.
Hold on 1 second, Anna. Listen, I'm gonna say this to you. My mom had cancer two times. She went through chemotherapy, lost her hair. She grew it back. She still wears her natural hair. Most men, especially black men, believe a woman's hair is their glory. That's your glory. Whether it's short, whether it's long, whether it's 4C, your hair is your glory. When you're wearing someone else's hair on your head, you're not you. You're someone else. That's not you. You're someone else. I want you. I don't care if your hair is 4C and nappy and kinky. I don't care if it's long, if it's short. I want you.
Okay, I get that bit. I have a question. How about for people who are suffering from like hair loss issues, like alopecia, and they don't feel confident with how they look, and they want to wear wigs because of that? How about those kind of people?
I have no problem with that. I just told you, my mom had cancer. She never wore a wig. Ever. My mom had cancer, never wore a wig, not one day in her life. Never. A lot of you guys have an emotional crutch on these wigs. It's an emotional thing. Your self-esteem, I'm not talking about you, Anna, but your self-esteem is tied to these wigs. Without it, you don't even feel confident enough to go out in public. You don't even feel confident enough to come on camera. You don't even feel confident enough to go on a date. You don't even feel confident enough to show the dude that you're dating around the house.
Mm-hmm.
We men want you. We want who you are. We don't want who you're purporting to be.
Okay, I have another question. So what if a woman can just wear the wig during outdoors, and when you're indoors with your man, you're comfortable enough to remove the wig?
Why aren't you
in your natural like?
But why aren't you comfortable enough to wear it outdoors though? Is what I think that's the sociological answer that we got to get to. Why aren't you comfortable enough to wear your own hair outside?
You just answered it a while back because you said women feel like emotionally attached to this hair, right? And they don't feel confident enough walking out. They don't feel beautiful enough.
And that means you need therapy.
It's not therapy. It's just like the way we do nails.
No, that's therapy. Like, you need therapy. If you don't feel, if your nails are chipped, you still go outside. If you need a fill-in, you still go outside. You still go to work. If your eyelashes need to be redone, you still go to work. You still go outside.
So how is it that you're comfortable with someone wearing lashes but not a wig?
Because
same
of wig.
Difference.
Because
like, what's the difference?
Let me ask you a question. What's the first thing that people do when they want to alter their appearance in movies to escape? What's the first thing that they do? What's the first thing they do in movies? What's the first thing they do to become a different person?
They change their hair?
Exactly. They change their hair. So that means your hair is greatly tied to your identity of who you are.
Mm-hmm.
So if you're wearing wigs all the time, that's not you. We're not dating you.
So if you're okay with someone wearing a wig, but not all the time.
I don't date.
Is that what you're saying?
I don't date women who wear wigs at all. At all. No chance. If you wear a wig, I don't date you, period. That's
don't
a red line.
Think you're the one who has issues? Don't you think you're the one who has issues and not the woman? It's a preference. It's a preference that you have to date women who don't wear wigs. It's your preference.
Yeah. It's my preference.
Cool.
Thank you. Hey, Ada, how you doing?
I'm doing good. I had to come on because I think it was a couple weeks ago. You got me and you were like, turn your camera on. And I had combed my hair. So, yep.
I like your hair. Okay. You got that natural hair.
Thank you. Thank you very
much. That your hair looks good.
Thank you very much. I'll take that. But I have a question. So, can you help me understand why some men think that having like a preference, like you said, for a woman to not wear wigs or whatever, Why do you feel so strongly about it whenever women have preferences also for men, but usually are more flexible about, those requirements, whether they be like vein requirements, or appearance requirements?
Well, a lot of people meet on dating apps, and if a man is under 6 feet tall, his dating options, his matches drop by 90%. I mean, women are asking that men make $100,000 a year when only 10% of the population do. On dating apps, women, 80% of women swipe on 10% of the men. You guys' preferences are pretty well stated. But when men have preferences, we get backlash for our preferences. And I just personally don't think that that is fair. If I want a woman who wears her own natural hair and who's under 165 pounds, I should not be shamed for that. I should not be saying that people shouldn't say I'm fatphobic. I'm 181 pounds. I'm 5 foot 11. I want to be able to easily pick up my woman and throw her over my shoulder. I lift when I go to the gym. I bench press 225 pounds because that's what they do in the NFL combine. And I try to max out that bench press. So if I got a woman that's 290 pounds and we're in a fire and I try to pick her up, and I can't, and I fall and hurt my back, and we both burn up. I wasn't able to do my job as a man and protect her.
Okay, I can see where you're coming from. I do. I can see where you're coming from. I think when people hear, or I know when I hear, like when I scrolled past your live before, and I heard some, what I would consider to be like, maybe like preferences, and the delivery was like kind of like angry or maybe like critical, like criticism. Of course, people become defensive, whether it's men or women. So, anyway, that's why I hopped on because I was just trying to get clarity.